In this video, we will start creating a manufacture project based on this solid, and we created this solid during the Fusion 360 course from scratch, which you will find on my channel, and I will put the link to this course in the description of this video. And now we will move on to creating a manufacture project. Go to the manufacture module, and to start the project, click this icon, create a new setup, and here, as you can see, a default stock has been created. Stock is our initial material from which we will mill this part, and of course we can change it, we will go to it in a moment, but at the beginning let's select the type of operation, select milling, then we can specify the position of the origin of the coordinate systems. I'll call it the base. Here are the points that we can select as the origin of the coordinate systems, and we can choose one of 27 points. If you want to have a base in the middle and at the top of the part, select this point. Here are other options for determining the position of the origin, however, these 27 points are currently sufficient. We set the base in the middle of this object in the XY axis and at the top of this object in the Z axis. Then go to the stock, and here we can determine the dimensions of the stock. By default, the stock is selected in such a way that the model has been enlarged to certain dimensions per side. We have a relative size box here, and we just added 1 mm of the allowance to the side and 1 mm to the top of the part. At this point, we can leave it, but we can also choose the option fixed size box, and here you can specify the specific dimensions of the stock. If, for example, you have some material and you will not cut this material specifically to make such a part, then you can simply specify the dimensions of this material. But we go back to the relative size box parameter and leave 1 mm of the allowance to the side, and 1 mm of the allowance to the top. Then the post-process tab, where we specify the number of the program, we can specify the comment, and we have a parameter here that can specify that we will work on a different work offset than the standard G54. So if you enter 1 here, a program based on G55 will be generated, but that's a topic for another lesson. We leave 0 here, we haven't changed anything here. Click OK to confirm it, and in this way we have created a stock and started a manufacture project. I will save this project under a different name, select the file, save as, and here I save it as P1CAM. So to have a separate project for modeling and a separate project for the manufacture, click save. And a short supplement, at this point it is also worth saying what the base is. And we call the base a coordinate system that we define both in the Fusion 360 and on the CNC machine. And what we defined in the Fusion 360 should be defined in the same way on the CNC machine. If in the Fusion 360 we define the base in the middle of this part in the axis XY and at the top in the Z axis, we should also it on the machine. Because the machining program that we generate from the Fusion 360 is generated on the basis of the toolpaths that we will add to this project, and this program will be generated in relation to this coordinate system. As you know, the machining program is a text file that contains a series of characters, a series of coordinates XYZ. And these coordinates are calculated in relation to the origin of this coordinate system that we have defined here. So the base on the machine should be defined in the same place, because the machining program on the machine will be performed in relation to the coordinate system that we define. If this coordinate system were to be defined elsewhere, there could be a collision. So it is necessary to pay special attention to the base that we define in the Fusion 360, was defined in the same place on the CNC machine, because it is a kind of reference. In the case of the Fusion 360, it is a reference to which this program will be generated. And in the case of the CNC machine, it is a reference to which this CNC program will be performed. So you have to take care of it and make sure that there is no discrepancy between the Fusion 360 and the CNC machine. And that's it. Link to other lessons is in the description of this video.